It's the continuation of the second lecture of some theorem on tree for BTEC CSE section A and B. It's the last lecture for module 5. We'll introduce some more theorem related to tree. So we move to the next theorem. The theorem says a graph G has a spanning tree if and only if. We start from here. Theorem number 7 is not mentioned in the previous lecture, so we start from here. The number of internal vertices, that is non-pendant vertex, in a binary tree is 1 less than the number of the pendant vertex. If we follow the last lecture, you can recognize that we use a theorem for binary trees. Number of pendant vertex is n plus 1 by 2. So if you want to find without any calculation of 25 vertex in a binary tree, then how many number of pendant vertex there are? Using this theorem n plus 1 by 2, we can find 25 plus 1 by 2, that is 13. So 13 be the number of pendant vertex. Therefore, the non-pendant vertex, excluding the pendant vertex, is known as the non-pendant vertex, should be 25 minus of 13, that is 12, which is less than 1 of the pendant vertex. This shows the theorem. So we move to the proof of this theorem. So, proof of the theorem: a non-empty vertex in a binary tree, a non-pendant vertex in a binary tree is called an internal vertex. First, we define which is non-pendant vertex. Let x be the number of pendant vertex and y be the number of non-pendant vertex. Initially, we consider the number of pendant vertex is x and the number of non-pendant vertex is y. So according to the basic idea of U, if a graph consists exactly n number of vertices, then the number of vertices that should be equals to the number of vertices that should be equals to the addition of the pendant vertex plus non-pendant vertex. Okay, addition of the pendant vertex plus non-pendant vertex. Again, from a previous theorem, we have already learned that the number of pendant vertex x should be equals to the number of vertex plus 1 by 2, n plus 1 by 2. So here we put the value of n from this relation. Here we put the value of n, exactly the value of n. N is replaced by x plus y, so here we replace x plus y plus 1 by 2. Just to multiply it by 2, the result becomes 2x equals to x plus y plus 1. So after calculation, x minus 2x minus 6, it becomes x, and this one becomes minus 1, so y becomes x minus of 1, which represent that y is the non-pendant vertex and x is the pendant vertex. That means pendant vertex minus of 1, that should be equals to the non-pendant vertex. That is says in the theorem. Hence, the number of internal vertex is equals to number of pendant vertex minus of 1. Internal vertex equals to number of pendant vertex minus of 1. Next, we move to the next theorem. It's the last theorem for spanning tree, and this lecture should be the last lecture for module 5, because we have already learned in your class all the theorem and all the related topic in the graph theory. The remaining portion is discussed here. So the last theorem is: a graph G has a spanning tree if and only if G is connected. It says that a graph G has a spanning tree if and only if G is connected. That means we can say that if a graph has a connected graph, then it must have a spanning tree. Then it must have a spanning tree. Okay. So it says that if the graph is a connected graph, it must have a spanning tree. That is in two different ways. One is the necessary condition, another one is the sufficient condition. So we start from the necessary condition. What should be the necessary condition? Suppose GBA graph having a spanning tree. First we consider G is a graph having a spanning tree, then you have to prove that the graph G should be a connected graph. The next part, that should be the sufficient part. We just consider G is a connected graph, then it must have a spanning tree. Okay. So we start the first part of the theorem. To prove the first part of the theorem, suppose G be a graph having a spanning tree, say the spanning tree is T. Let V1, V2 are the two arbitrary vertices of G. Just we consider V1, V2 be any two arbitrary vertices of G. Since T contains all the vertices of G, because T is a spanning tree, the definition of spanning tree says that the spanning tree should consist every vertices of the graph. So T should consist the vertices V1 and V2. T should contain the vertices V1 and V2. And V1 and V2 belong to T, then V1 V2 should be belong to 2. Since T is a tree, it's a very important line. It's a very important line since it is given that T is a tree, then it should be connected. According to the definition, it says that it should be connected, and for that reason we can say that V1 and V2 are connected by a path in T, because T is a spanning tree. This line is the most valuable line in this particular proof. Since T is a subgraph of G, because we just consider T is a spanning tree of the graph G, that means every vertex of the graph of the tree should be belongs to G, and every edge of tree should be belongs to G. Therefore T should be a subgraph of the graph G. Therefore V1 V2 is also connected by a path in G, because V1 V2 is connected by a path in T. Therefore T is a subgraph of the graph G. Therefore V1 V2 should connected by a path in G, because G is the supergraph. Hence G is connected. Hence the result follows, because we just consider T is the spanning tree, any two vertex must have a path. Therefore they must connected. T is a subgraph of the graph G. So if T is connected, G should be connected. Okay. Next we move to the next part of the theorem, sufficient condition. We have already mentioned that when we prove the sufficient condition, you have to remember that suppose that G is a connected graph, and if the connected graph G has no circuit, if G is connected and has no circuit, then G should be itself is a spanning tree. Okay. So it is own spanning tree. But when we cannot say G is a connected graph, but still it's not a spanning tree, it is only happen when G has a cycle. Okay. When G has a cycle or a circuit. So here we consider if G has a circuit. If G has a no circuit, then itself is a spanning tree. But if G has a circuit, what happened? G has a circuit, then what should be happen? If G has a circuit, then you can easily delete a edge from the circuit. Still the graph should be connected graph, because it's a circuit. That means there must exist two vertex of the graph where the number of path from these two vertex is more than one. That means you can easily delete one, two or three number of edges. How many number of edges required to connect the path? Then you can easily delete a edge or a two edge or three edge, whatever may be the case. We just remove the circuit from the graph. The delete an edge from the circuit, this will still have the length of the graph, still leave the graph connected. Still the graph should be connected. If this graph has no circuit, if we consider if this graph has no circuit, then this graph G is a connected graph, and any two vertex must have a path, so it must have a spanning tree. Otherwise, what happened? It may be happened that after deletion of one edge, the still the graph has more circuit. In that case, you again delete another edge from the graph. The graph still becomes a connected graph. If this connected graph has no circuit, then it should be a tree. If it's not happened, then again we delete another edge to perform to delete another circuit case, and again we find a connected graph, still should be a connected graph. And if this connected graph has no circuit, then it should be a tree. And this process should be continued. This process should be continued until we can find a connected graph, connected graph, subgraph of the graph G, which is connected but has no circuit. So we can find the spanning tree of the graph. So it's your last theorem, and stop this particular topic. And happy learning. Wait for some study, wait for some practice question. Follow the forum to ensure to solve different type of question for your practice. Thank you and happy learning.